Are you struggling to connect your Airtable data to your Softr app? It's a good thing I'm making this video, because the video you're watching right now is going to be me diving in on how to connect your Airtable data to your Softr app, also how to connect multiple data sources to your Softr app, and even dive into how to filter that data once you have it in there. Whether you're building a new app from scratch or you're using one of our great templates, this video is going to show you how to connect things from your Airtable to Softr right now. So when starting from scratch, we can first press new application, and then let's press blank application here. So the key thing here is that we're going to want to make sure we select Airtable and then press continue. We're then going to be prompted to connect to our Airtable via an API key. If you click right here, it'll actually bring you to your Airtable account page. And you can also get there by going to Airtable, then clicking right here, going to Developer Hub. And then once you're there, you can go to the API key, click on this, then copy it, go back into your Softr app, and then paste it in there. For the purposes of this video, I'm just gonna use some of these example items here. So we can press Create Application, and it's gonna have some preset dynamic blocks with no data in there. So we can go to Pages, for example, and let's go to this list block right here. You obviously can go to the Add Block section and add a different block. So like this one, for example, and then once it's created, we can select a data source. So the data source I'm gonna pick here is actually going to be a property management one. So if I click property management, then within that, inside of Airtable, you'll see that there's all these different tables that I have here, and you can always create new tables or remove the current ones you have by right clicking and deleting table. Essentially in Softr, it brings in the base, which is the entirety of this thing. You can see on the top left from the property management base, and then we can pull in the specific table from within there. So let's just pick the units table, for example. And you'll see Softr smartly brings in the image into this, which gotta give it credit, it's pretty smart. And now Softr doesn't copy your data when it's bringing this in here. It works directly with the API, so it's like a one-to-one connection. So it means the changes are real time and your data is not necessarily being cloned. It's just interacting with the original data source. And when connecting to the system, it will do its best effort to match fields from the data source to the UI, and then the user can change it. So for example, like what I said with the image, I can now change different things. Like it has the monthly rent right here, and it has what's very smart, which is the name in the header, which is honestly what I'd want. I'm not gonna change that. Good on you, Softr. And I can obviously hide or show this divider. For my purposes, I'm gonna change this and delete it, and then change this to a text for address. And then furnishings, I'm gonna keep as this tag. I like how that looks. And I can make it different colors, so I could have it as defined source, which is nice. So I know whether it is furnished or not, or partially furnished. And then I can change this bathrooms to a text showcase as well. And then even duplicate this and show the bedrooms, and then change it to bedrooms. And boom, you can see all the different data that's coming through here is gonna be matched one-to-one with, and not copying, but working with the data that we had from this units table right here. I can also pick from one of the great templates that Softr has. So if I go back here, you can see that there's all these awesome templates to choose from. I'm gonna pick this employee directory. So what I can do is press use template and then pick Airtable and then press continue. Now, once again, we can go to my Airtable account page, copy the API key. Now it's gonna ask you, do you wanna copy this to your Airtable account since it is a template? I'm gonna wanna do that, or use your existing base by starting from blank. Personally, I'm gonna copy the base to my account to get some example data in there. And you'll see, it's gonna ask me where I wanna put it. I'm gonna just put it in my first workspace, press add base, then boom, it's all connected in there. Now you can see I have all these different tables to choose from. And if I go create application, it's going to take that data and create this employee directory inside of Softr. Then if we go to this section right here and we click on it, you'll see that it's connecting to that Airtable base, which is employee directory by Softr. and the employee directory table right there is connected. So let's go back into Airtable, employee directory by Softr, and boom, we got this right here. Now, obviously, just like with the other one, we could change any of the fields we want. I'll be honest, Softr's designers do a much better job than me, so I would probably keep it how it is. But I would maybe add another field as text to date of birth, remove that label. And then pro tip, you can always check out how it was default styled by going here, taking a look at this and essentially just copying the settings. That's for another video, but just like with doing it from scratch, you can obviously add these different fields or delete them. So going back to my property management one that I'm making from scratch, this application is gonna have the opportunity to show you how we can filter data in Softr. So first and foremost, if I go into the source section here on my list block and I scroll down, I can click on conditional filters. Now what these are is essentially they are requiring the data to pass through a first filter before we're able to see the rest of it. And then when we'll get to the inline filters in a second, those are essentially going to be interactive filters that we can utilize once the app is in viewing mode. For example, in this case, let's filter to a specific use case of tenants. So we can pick specific names of things or whether a field is empty or not. So I'm gonna pick where tenants is not empty. And you'll see here that then it tells me editing mode doesn't show accurate filtered results. We have to actually go into preview mode to see only the units where the tenants aren't empty in this case. So you'll see only a few should pop up. That's right, only these three popped up. It's worth mentioning that conditional filters are done server side and it's a security mechanism. So essentially you can prevent people from seeing data if they're not a logged in user. Now, once these three are popped up, what I'm then gonna show you is pretty nice. We essentially can do an inline filter, which is that next level. What if I wanted to only see ones that were furnished or partially furnished? We then, as you can see here, if I interact with the data source, I'm gonna show you for this example that this one's gonna be furnished. And then I'm gonna refresh this page so that we have an example for the furnishing to have three options. So you can see some of the beautiful color things that Softr can do. If we go back in here and go to the content section, you'll see that there are options for inline filters. Now these inline filters can be up top here or on the side in some cases as well. You can see that there's positions for left, right. So you can see here, right, over here, or on the top. I'm just gonna leave the one on the top and I can press delete here. I'm gonna change this to furnishings and then we're gonna filter it by the column in Airtable, furnishings. And then you'll see here, it's got the three options, cool. And I can have it do a multi-select so I can select more than just one at a time. But not only that, what's really cool is that since it's synced with the data source here, I can then press as defined in data source, or I can pick specific colors, right? But let's just do as defined by data source. So as defined by data source, you'll see, and I press preview that we got green and this other color as well. So if I press partial, it'll just show me partial here. And then since we allowed multi-select, we can also see the furnished options and the unfurnished options as well. If you want to, you can easily change this to not allow multi-select. And that would just mean that when we go into the preview setting and we're interacting with this application, that it only lets you select one at a time. So say for example, I only wanted to see furnished and then I only wanted to see partial, it would go to that specific tag that I picked. Thanks so much for joining me and learning more on how to connect Airtable to your Softr app, as well as how to connect multiple data sources and how to filter your data in Softr. Thank you so much, and we'll see you in the next one.